posted for 199.
I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, to be this fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord of God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God, number 27. Not by the poor people, but only by certain witnesses God had chosen beforehand. Now we are those witnesses. We have eaten and drunk with him after his resurrection from the dead. He has ordered us to declare this to his people and to tell them that God has appointed him to judge everyone, alive or dead. It is to him that all prophets bear this witness, that all who believe in Jesus will have their sins forgiven through his name. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For the sing the responsorial song.
She saw that the stone had been moved away and the tomb,
Simon Peter and little Simon, the one Jesus loved. "We have taken the Lord out of the tomb," she said, "and we don't know where they put him." So Peter set out with the other disciple to go to the tomb. They ran together, but the other disciple, running faster than Peter, reached the tomb first. He bent down and saw the linen cloths lying on the ground, but did not go in. Simon Peter, who was following now, came up, went right into the tomb, saw the linen cloths on the ground, and also the cloth that had been over his head. This was not with the linen, but rolled up in place by itself. Then the other disciples, who had reached the tomb first, also went in. He saw and believed. Till this moment he had failed to understand the teaching of Scripture, that he must rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear friends in Christ, the feast of Easter is celebrating the victory of Jesus over death and mankind's hope for eternal life. This feast gives us a new hope of our own resurrection at the end times, and at the same time, it keeps us all one with the living Christ, who will be always with us. The theme of today's Mass includes both proclamation and witnessing. Saint Paul tells us that if Jesus is not risen from the dead, our faith is in vain. In the Gospel, Mary Magdalene is asked to go and proclaim the resurrection to all. To the disciples, the resurrection was a new experience. It was a total transformation, and it gave them a new vision of life. They had been witness of his suffering and death, and during that time, they had remained hidden out of fear. Their hope in Jesus was scattered, but the resurrection brought about a complete turnaround, and they began boldly to proclaim that Jesus, who died on the cross, was alive and with them. Later, when they were arrested, persecuted, and imprisoned, they rejoiced as they were now even more closely related to the life experience of their Lord through his resurrection. Easter Sunday was totally a reversal of the image of the Good Friday. His death, which seemed to be a defeat before the world, is now shown as a triumph over sin and death. The resurrection of Jesus is a mystery which cannot be humanly comprehended. Through it, Jesus enters into a new realm of life. He will not die again, and his new existence is beyond all understanding. The risen Jesus enters a completely new way of living. That's why the Gospels are not able to explain the Easter mystery and the resurrection. The Gospels have just used more human terms and speak of the empty tomb, his sudden appearance, eating with them, walking with them, teaching them, and commissioning them. One thing is certain, that the disciples are aware of his total presence. They know that he is with them and will remain with them. Ultimately, that Easter is a celebration of the complete, unending love of the Father for the sake of the humanity. He gave back his Son to us for humankind with great love, and with the resurrection, Jesus will stay with us forever. Today's Gospel, from the Gospel of St. John, draws our attention to the empty tomb
as a sign of the resurrection of the Lord. It was the first day of the Sabbath, first day of the Christian week, when Mary Magdalene came to the tomb, as it was a Jewish custom for someone to visit the dear one's tomb after their burial. On the way to the tomb, Mary was preoccupied with this question: who is going to tear away the stone for me? Mary had no idea that Jesus would be there. Mary was expecting to see the dead body of Jesus, a body without life. But at the end of the homily, I'll tell you what surprise Jesus gave to Mary. Same thing with Peter and John. When Mary went and told them that somebody has stolen the body of Jesus, they both ran towards the tomb. And for their surprise too, Jesus gave them a gift of coming close to them in real life. For all of them, dear friends, this resurrection was a transformation. And they understood it clearly on their way to Emmaus when Jesus explained the positive meaning of the suffering of the Messiah as found in the Old Testament. And the resurrection of Jesus brought a new hope in the disciples and transformed their emptiness into a fullness of life. The word Jesus is alive. I have seen the Lord, well enough to instantly create a great spiritual hunger in the soul of the worldly minds of disciples, and they suddenly become altered to the truth. Faith was being reinstated in the words that Jesus had spoken while he lived on earth. Dear friends, the Feast of Easter is a confirmation of our own faith. Our faith is deeply rooted and finds its real meaning in the resurrection of the Lord. And our faith tells us that Good Friday and the death of Jesus is not the climax of the Holy Week. It's only a part in the achievement of the final resurrection. The cross was the high point of Jesus given to himself to the Father for our sake, and the Father returns that gift to us in the form of the resurrected Lord. Accordingly, today's Mass invites us with an invitation to proclaim the good news and to be a witness to the risen Lord. Dear friends, we are a resurrection people. Easter, the Feast of Resurrection, gives us the joyful message that we are a resurrection people. This means that we are not supposed to be lie buried in the tomb of our sins, our evil habits, our dangerous addictions. It gives us the good news that no tombs can hold us down any longer. Not the tombs of despair, discouragement, doubt, or death itself. Instead, we are expected to live a joyful and peaceful life, constantly experiencing the real presence of the risen Lord in our lives. Secondly, we need to always remember Easter in our Good Fridays. We have more of Good Fridays in our lives rather than Easter Sundays. Easter reminds us that every Good Friday in our lives will have an Easter Sunday, that Jesus will let us share the power of his resurrection. Each time we display our love for others, we share in the resurrection. Each time we face a betrayal of trust, and with the Lord's grace, when we can forgive the betrayal and forget the offense, we share in the resurrection of the Lord. Each time we fall in our attempts to ward off our temptations, but keep on trying to overcome them, we share in the resurrection. Each time we continue to hope, Even when our hope seems unanswered, we share in the power of resurrection. In short, the message of Easter is that nothing can destroy us. No pain, no sin, no rejection, no betrayal or death. Because Christ has conquered all these, and we too can conquer them if we put our faith and trust in Him. Remember always Mary Magdalene. As I said, she was preoccupied with this thought of who will tear that huge stone from him so that she can get inside the tomb and anoint the body of Jesus. Dear friends, often there are preoccupations that hinder or becomes a huge stone between me and my Lord. You and your Lord. Maybe it can be attachment to people and things. It can be our worries. It can be our sickness. It can be our concern about the future. There can be so many stones that can come between us. Huge rocks, huge blocks. We need to only ask the Lord. He will turn back this. Turn away these, or roll away these stones for us, so that we can have a glimpse of Him, glimpse of the risen Lord in our life, in our faith life. Many of us expecting to see a lifeless body, but she has given the privilege to see the risen Lord. Maybe because of our preoccupations, we may not be able to see the Lord immediately. But with the grace of God, He will give us a chance to have a glimpse of Him in our life. And that's exactly happened in the Holy Eucharist. When we receive Him in the Holy Communion, He is coming right into our life. What a gift that He can give to us this Sunday morning, coming into our personal life as our Savior and our Lord. Dear friends, when those moments of despair and hardships come, always remember to spread the good news like Mary Magdalene, who said, "He is alive. I have seen the Lord." God bless us.
We have the renewal of our baptismal promises. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water He has created, which will be sprinkled upon us as a memorial of our baptism. May He graciously renew us that we may remain faithful to the Spirit whom we have received. Lord our God, in your mercy, we present your people who keep vigil on this most sacred night, and for us who recall the wondrous work of our creation and the still greater work of our redemption. Graciously bless this water, for you created water to make the field fruitful and to refresh and cleanse our bodies. You also made water the instrument of your mercy. For through water you freed your people from slavery and quenched their thirst in the desert. Through water the prophets proclaimed the good news, the new covenant you were to enter upon with the human race. And last of all, through water which Christ made holy the Jordan, you gave renewed and corrupted nature in the bath of regeneration. Therefore, May this water be for us a memorial of the baptism we have received. And grant that we may share in the gladness of our brothers and sisters who at Easter have received their baptism through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, for the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so, now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of the holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his foes, and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his foes?
I do.
And all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
Amen.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life.
Let us pray that the resurrection of Jesus Christ will imbue us with a new life, that is, the life that will shine into our souls, banishing the darkness of sin. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
hear
us.
Let us pray, giving thanks for the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, fulfilling his promise to give us life, life in abundance. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Let us pray that the newly baptized and confirmed will find in the Church joy, happiness, and support in their spiritual growth, and that their devotion may may be an inspiration to us all. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Let us pray for a renewal of devotion to Christ in the Blessed Sacrament, that transformed by what we receive, we may provide inspiration to all around us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Let us pray for the sake of the parish and for the sake of our families, that they may find comfort to bear their suffering, fortified by the real presence of Christ in the Blessed Sacrament, and that they may soon be delivered from their suffering.
Lord,
hear us. Let's pray for those that have died recently, and for those whose anniversaries fall at this time. May they rest in the peace of Christ and inherit the promise of eternal life. May the souls of all the faithful of God, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
For a few moments, let us pray the silence of our own hearts for our own petitions.
Blessed are you, O God, for creation. For through your goodness, we have received the bread we offer you. Throw out the earth and work of human hands, and give them for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
For your goodness, we have received the wine we offer you. Lord, the wine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Brothers and sisters, let my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Remember the Lord as a sacrifice as your hands. Upon the face of all your physique, God will be the Lord of all your spirit. Accepted this passive gladness and offer. You offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to obey you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to love you and to more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true, he is the Lamb, who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our debts, and by rising, he restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exulting in praise, and even with the heavenly powers, with the angelic host, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as the young lady. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Grant a peace. God, unite and govern them throughout the whole world. Together with your servant, Pope Francis, Malcolm our bishop, and all those who hold in the truth, hand on to the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Promote the Lord, dear servants, and all who are gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. Father, we offer you this sacrifice of praise. Father, you offer it for themselves and all who are near to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the most glorious ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, their spouse, and your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints, we ask for their merits and prayers. In all things we may be defended by your protecting hand. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our ways in your peace, and command that we be delivered from the eternal damnation, and covered among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless and acknowledge and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of the most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your people, offer to your glorious majesty and the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angels to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also all your servants. Sit and tell him one prayer, who have gone before us with the Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. Those also your servants, who those in us, we hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Our teachers, we beseech you into their company, not being our own merits, but granting us your pardon, through whom you continue to make all things good, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
also the word of God which we have learned, as well as the affliction of this parish community. Ask for the prayers of those whom you visit in your temple. Go now into our space. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that, renewed with past ministries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For we have heard and prayed for this blessing. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in the compassion, defend you from every assault of sin. Amen. And may hope restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten Son, endow you with the price of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion has drawn to a close, may you, who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal feast, come with Christ's help and exalting in spirit to those feasts